You seem to be concentrating just fine on the junior lieutenant at the reception for Captain Stadius.
She was a poor substitute for you.
Her name is Terry Farrell, and she plays the Trill symbiote Dax on Star Trek Deep Space Nine.
Try a high-pitched sonic shower. It'll make you feel better.
No, it won't. I've already tried it.
The role of Dax for the former fashion model is quite a challenge.
Sorry I'm late. I was having dinner with Julian.
How is our young doctor?
Young. It's never boring to look at this dialogue. It's always a new creature, a new alien, a new situation that we're in. I mean, the station's in jeopardy.
What do you have, Dax?
In the last hour alone, the rupture's expanded 27%. The rate of expansion is increasing.
Can we gain any time by moving the station?
If the rift collapses, the implosion would overtake us almost immediately.
I think what's nice about it is to have, I don't know, a traditional job that would be for a man. It gives my character more, I have more room to explore everything. Instead of going from being feminine to have to be masculine and take control of a situation, I can take control and be sensitive about it.
Action, please.
I know. I cared about him, too.
These are on the house.
Okay.
This year, my character's a little bit more open than she was last year. That gives me more to work with, and that makes it more fun for me to go to work. And what excites me is when little kids will come to me, little girls, and, you're my hero. And you think, wow, I don't realize that I'm affecting somebody because I'm generally at work. I'm not out that much. I don't go out too much. But that makes me feel really good. And it's nice that a little girl will think, well, I want to be like that. And I'm playing somebody who's intelligent and centered and somebody who's cares about life and protecting people. And she has her priorities in order.
It's exciting to watch.
When Farrell is not on the Deep Space Nine set, she is here at the Gun Club, practicing for a role in an upcoming film.
I did it for Red Sun Rising, a film I did this summer. But I did it a couple times with friends before. Took lessons with a policeman being there. And it was interesting because they talk about statistics and how people get shot at home and how many handgun, scary stuff. But so then the officer talks about how if you know how to use the gun, if it's around, it's safer. And it made it more fun for playing a cop on Red Sun Rising to actually go work with a lieutenant at Culver City to police. You okay?
She really falls apart in between shots. This has been 10 minutes. 10 minutes.
That's true.
Okay. My close-up,
ready, ready?
5 seconds.
We'll check our lineup.
This one, 10 minutes in between shots.
Use this, Mark.
Bicycle?
Joking around makes it so much easier. I mean, when you have to talk what we call technobabble, if you took it too serious, like I did last year, you get upset with yourself, and it makes it too hard to do it. Now it's, what was it?
Could this be related to the increased thoron emissions in the plasma field?
Thoron emissions? I think you'd better ask me, Benjamin.
My favorite one last year was one called Wishes Were Horses. And I had to play two Daxes. All our imaginations went wild, and what we were actually thinking came true, came to be. And I had to play Dax. And Dax's fantasy was that this horrible thing was going to happen to the station. It was going to be a repeat in some disaster that happened in history. And what happened to Sadiq al-Fadil Bashir? Dax, his fantasy of Dax came to life.
Jadzia.
Hello, Julian.
What are you doing here?
Watching you. Waiting for you to wake up.
I'm awake.
Is something wrong?
Funny. I was about to ask you the same question. must be this Larosian virus that's been going around. How do you feel?
Wonderful.
No fever. It must be me. Must be an allergic reaction to the reclamated antipasto I had at lunch. Perhaps. I must be hallucinating.
Why are you fighting this?
Why am I fighting this? Why am I fighting this? I have no good answer to that question.
Roll it, please.
Spit.
Spit!
These, are on the house.
How come?
I thought we'd have a toast to the memory of Chief O'Brien and Dr. Bashir.
That's very thoughtful, Quark.
With the success of Deep Space Nine, does playing Dax for the next several years limit her?
I don't think that's something to be concerned about with... First of all, I never played anybody like Dax before. And secondly, to have my hiatus to do something different. I mean, this hiatus, I played a socialite and a detective. It couldn't be further from Dax. So that was fun, and that made me more excited to come back to the second season. I think that part of it helps.
Lieutenant, stop denying all those yearnings you feel. Yearnings? If you don't, you'll never know what you missed.
Pattern match found.
Just in the nick of time.
Next month, we'll talk to Star Trek's highest-ranking female, executive producer Jeri Taylor.